Hi there, it's Lou again, aka Jachinoy. For today's video, I would like to continue my Singapore video, Singapore journey, and probably I'll just title this video like what I like, why I like working and living here in Singapore. So if you would like to know my thoughts, then keep on watching. Okay, hi there. If you're new to my channel, my name is Lou, aka Jachinoy15. I'm a Filipina working and living here in Singapore for about, I believe, 13 years. So I was single at that time when I transferred here with my boyfriend. I got married here, I got kids here, and we're still going strong here in Singapore. So I believe I can share with you what I think about it, why I like working and living here in Singapore. Actually, I really highly recommend Singapore for everybody. That's why I made a list on why, like me, wants to be, you know, away from my country and, you know, living and staying here in Singapore. First of all, in every other people, this is the number one why they are here. I always tell my friends, because of the money. Yes, I'm here for the money. Because money, the compensation and the salary for work is really, really high. I will never get this kind of salary in the Philippines. Me, I work as an admin in an office, and what I got right now, well, I will never have that in the Philippines, even though I'm on my same state. And of course, here in Singapore, it's really, really big money. Everybody's thinking, probably Lou, you're just thinking it's big money because you convert it into pesos. Yes, that is true, because if you're converted to pesos, because for us in the Philippines, one Singapore dollars is about 35 pesos, the going rate. Yes, I am kind of rich when I go back home to the Philippines, because I have big, my conversion of dollars is kind of big. However, however, here in Singapore, when I buy a chicken rice, for example, chicken rice is $3, that's already 100 pesos. That is the same thing as well. So you cannot compare to other people like, oh, you convert it to peso like this. I cannot convert it anymore. Actually, me, I stopped converting already, because I earn Singapore dollar and I expense it in Singapore dollar as well. I notice if you really know how to budget, you will have a lot of savings afterwards, even after your usual expenses like your rent, your personal things, and your whatsoever. You can still save a lot of money. The salary here is really, really good. Even though you're in a blue collar job, in the office, or whatsoever field, I do believe the salary is really good. That's why that is the number one thing. That's why I like living here in Singapore and working here, because I can see that the standard of living here is great, and the salary that commensurate on your job title is great as well. Nothing like, well, I'm just comparing the Philippines, okay, because I work in the Philippines before, and I'm thinking like, in the Philippines, wow, our salary there is kind of really, really low. Even though I'm staying with my mom, sometimes I give money to my mom. I'm like thinking, wow, how can a single person, you know, afford to have a rent with that kind of salary and the deduction of the taxes? And just to let you know, the money is really good here, right? Taxes here in Singapore is really, really low. One of the lowest in all over the world. Even though it's the most expensive city or country in the world, it's one of the lowest for taxes. So yes, money. Number two, why I like working and living here in Singapore is, second is the travel, is the convenience, the public transportation like the bus, the MRT, and the taxis is really, really convenient for the travel. Why? Because I'm comparing this again in the Philippines. In the Philippines, I remember I just stay at somewhere in La Loma, and then my office is at ABS-CBN. Both are in Quezon City. I think the whole travel time is about 45 minutes to 1 hour. But you know what? I travel like about 2 hours. I prepare 2 hours before because the traffic there is really, really worse. Here in Singapore, the traffic here, there's really less traffic or no traffic here because they control the cars. And by that, in the Philippines, by the time you go to work, you're already sweating. Why? Because in the jeepneys, the queue are very, very long. Traffic are worse. There's a lot of people there. What else? In the MRT as well, the queue is very long, and a lot of times it's malfunctioning, and the taxi drivers there, it's like you're choosing passengers to where you are heading, which I find it funny because you shouldn't be choosing your destination. That's why you are called a taxi driver, right? Because you will follow the destination of the passenger. But anyways, I'm just saying that even before you go to your workplace, you're already sweating, you're already haggard. If you know the Filipino word, haggardness, for haggard versus bayon, yes, you're already haggard. So the time I remember, my work starts at 9 a.m. 7, I'm already in the office. Why? To avoid this traffic. Because of course, almost all offices starts at 8 or 9, right? So you should be super early. Then of course, school starts at 7. So need to be way, way early to avoid those haggardness. Here in Singapore, even though we have malfunctioning MRT, it's really a tiny bit only compared to my country. The travel here is really good. MRT bus or taxi, and it's really on time. So when you go to the office, you will not be that haggard. And oh my gosh, they're really fully aircon, really fully malfunctioning. In the Philippines, even though you already paid an MRT that got an aircon, a taxi who got an aircon, some of them are malfunctioning, but you are paying for the aircon, you know, vehicle. But anyways, the travel here is really, really good. 3 is the safetiness here. Okay, first of all, Singapore is one of the very fine countries here. Fine meaning everybody just fines from chewing gum, putting litter everywhere, or whatsoever. I believe picking flowers as well. Even picking up flowers, you could be fine if I'm not mistaken. So the safetiness here, I really, really like, because of course in work, you can choose work, right? But sometimes you need to do overtime work. So it's so hard to, you know, like for a girl like me as well, it's so hard to work or to go home late. Then there is no public transportation, or you're going to think twice about your safetiness. Here in Singapore, almost the bus and the MRT close at 12 midnight, and it's really, really safe here. Not like zero crime, but you know, at least it's safe here compared to other countries, compared to the Philippines. Number 4 is the cleanliness, okay? Why? Because I really, really like it to be clean. That's it. In the Philippines, well, I remember in the Philippines, there's a lot of things in the road, really. Like gum, chewed gum, rubbish, candy wrappers, and sometimes, you know, those dog poo or cat poo. It's like in the Philippines, you cannot just walk straight. You have to walk straight, look at the road, and you need to hug your bag. You have to put your, you know, your shoulder bag in front or your backpack in front. So it should be a front bag. So I'm like thinking, wow, I never thought there would be a country that could be safe, you know, which is here in Singapore. I can wear all my jewelry, earrings, necklaces, everything. Some people, wow, they wear everything to show off. I'm like thinking, if it's your money, right, you just show it off, and it's really, really safe here, right? I like it here. I like the safetiness here, and the cleanliness here. Oh my gosh, the cleanliness here. Each and every probably 1 meter, 2 meters, we got a rubbish bin. That's why nobody will have this kind of reason that they will litter or what. And the street sweepers, they always sweep the floor. I don't know, probably they have rotation, but you can see it's really, really clean here. And if your environment is clean even before you go to the office, your mindset is clean as well. It's clearer. And isn't it nice to go to your work and to go back to your home with a clean place? If it is, wow, it's really, really going to change your mindset and you don't want to come back. One is number 5 is the convenience. Like the convenience here in Singapore, like what I said a while ago, like the MRT, like the taxi and the, what they call this, the buses is really convenient because they have timing. So when they are supposed to be there at 8 a.m., they will be there. If they're late, like about, you know, 5 to 10 minutes late also, then the gap only. And if it's a peak hour, they will have lots of buses and trains. And if it's a lean time, then of course they have lesser one. The convenience here, like for example, we have fast internet as well. So if you are in IT, the internet here is really, really fast when you do programming or what. Me, I'm in admin. I like it so much here. There's no excuse why it will be faster. And if you know the WhatsApp conversation, just like Viber, I believe in the Philippines, we use Viber compared to WhatsApp. It's even faster compared to our single text messaging, SMS. So everybody at work, we use WhatsApp because you can add a lot of people, add groups, and everything there is there. So yeah, I like the convenience here. Number six is of course, I like in working and living here in Singapore because it's nearer to my country. I never get homesick because we have so many flights already. Then we have a lot of budget flights already going back to, if I want to go back to Manila or any other place. If you're a Filipino, then you have a province. It's already so easy to go back to Philippines. I know a lot of people, especially single dads or single moms who are working here in Singapore. Sometimes if they have extra money, they, after work on a Friday night, they already have their, in the morning, Friday morning, they bring their luggage. And at Friday night after work, they just go straight to Changi Airport. And they have we have a midnight flight going to Manila. And we have a Sunday midnight flight going back to Singapore. So you see, you don't need to apply for a leave. You can see your family and you can have a weekend in Manila or in the Philippines. That's why we have a joke saying like, oh, parang ginawa mo lang kiyapo ang Pilipinas. Meaning, it's just so near that you just compared it to a kiyapo. And our travel time, our flight time is just 3.5 hours. Then Changi Airport is very convenient, very nice. So you see, it's like you're not really wasting your time because at Friday night, you just sleep. And Saturday morning, you're already there, back home, together with your family. That's why I really like it. I never get homesick. I can go anytime back home in the Philippines. Number 7 is the food here. I really, really like the food here. Because in Singapore, it's kind of a mixed cultural country. Because in Singapore, we already got Malays, Indians, and Chinese, and what do you call this? And Western food. So that one, we really have a lot of array of food already. It's default. We can buy and purchase food. And you know what? There's a lot of Filipinos here. That's why we have a lot of Filipino food as well. And other kind of food that is already super, super accessible. That's why I like the food here as well. Because one day I can eat Japanese. Next day I can eat Thai food. And everything is in food court price. Everything is very accessible. Sometimes it's at your hawker center only below your HDB block. So yeah, the food here is really, really great. And of course, it's healthy as well. You know why? Because here in Singapore, they promote good eating habits. Like you should have your veggie, you should have your fruit. Because if your kids are studying here, that the school will really implement that. I really like it, and yeah, everything is accessible and the food is really, really, really great. Is the number 8. Why I like working here in Singapore as well, and even though I'm not homesick because I'm with my family, but if you're a single person, like, what do you call this, a single lady, single single guy or a single mom or a single dad working here in Singapore, there is a lot of Filipino communities in Singapore. You can join in the Catholic Mass, the people who are singing there, or the people who are servicing in the canteen whatsoever, or you can join the Couples for Christ, Singles for Christ. I'm just saying for Catholics, okay? And there's a lot of things here. Like, I think the last time they have also in the Yahoo chats, that the last time they always meet at Starbucks in Plaza Singapura. I don't know where are they right now. We have dance groups here, whatsoever, photography group, anywhere. We have a lot of clubs here, and there's a lot of Filipinos here. That's why you will never get homesick, because you will have always somebody to sort of lean on. And if you want to rent a place, there's always a Filipino who would rent out a place, who can share a room, a house for you. So yes. So for my number 9, I think I'll just close at number 9 because this is the only thing that I can think of. The last one is, it's really easy to travel if you are coming here in Singapore. Why? Okay, I'm not so sure if other people thought about it, but I already thought about it a lot of time, because I still hold a Philippine passport, because I'm still a Filipino, even though I'm a permanent resident. Permanent resident, I can stay here for about 5 years, so I just renew 5 years, 5 years, right? Even though I don't have work. But anyways, I noticed if I have a Philippine passport, because if you're in the Philippines, of course, Philippines, we need to apply visa. Going to Australia, US, whatsoever, oh my gosh. Because we are coming from a third world country, right? In the Philippines, if I apply to go to US or whatsoever, it's just so hard. You need to pay a lot of fees, right? Or probably you go to buy via travel agent or whatsoever. However, if you are working here in Singapore, if you have built a relationship in Singapore, even you're working as ESPAS, employment pass, or whatsoever here in Singapore, as long as you're coming here from Singapore, then you have a valid IC, the identification card, it's just so easy to travel. Why? Because not recently, like a couple years ago, our family went to Japan. We never paid for anything. It's when I applied on Monday with all my documents. Monday morning I apply, Wednesday I got already the visa. Yep, and they don't ask too much, a lot of things. Of course, they ask the usual things like the filled up form, bank statement, employment letters, stuff like that. But they never ask for fees. I remember my husband's family when they're coming from the Davao, because us, we're coming from Singapore and they are coming from Davao, and we're just all going to meet at, I think our meeting place is in Osaka, Japan. They even paid for it, and I think they even do it via travel agent, because you cannot just do it direct. That was like last 5 years ago. So yeah, I can remember that it's really, really easy to apply if you're going overseas. And what are the other countries that I've been? Like, for example, last year I've been to South Korea. You need a visa as well. If you're from the Philippines, you have to give a lot of documents. I think you need to pay or not. But anyways, but here in Singapore, I don't need to go to a travel agent, and it's even for free. In South Korea, when we went to Seoul, it's just like in Japan. I went there Monday morning, give my documents, and on Wednesday, I got my visa already. Yeah, so I noticed it's really, really easy to travel if you got a good relationship here in Singapore, if you are working from Singapore. Because a lot of my Filipino friends, when they applied, what is the hardest visa to get? Ah, US, right? Like US and UK, like those Shenzhen visa. For Shenzhen, it's okay. I just heard that your depart and your arrival, it should be there. So it's best if you got a London ticket, you should be coming to London as well. But the hardest one for Philippines to get a visa is for US. So you just need to get a schedule and just go to the US embassy, get an interview, and I don't think so you need even a flight ticket. I don't think so. In South Korea as well, they don't need a flight ticket. But yeah, so a lot of my friends are getting approved. Actually, I haven't heard somebody who's getting denied. So I'm like thinking, like me and my husband were thinking at that time, like, we're like thinking like, oh my gosh, for example, if we want to go to US, or because we wanted to go Europe as well, probably this coming June, we're like thinking, it's really, really good that Singapore has a good relationship. And of course, if you're working in Singapore, right, and if they see your employment letter, your bank statements, right, that you're earning Singapore dollars, they're going to think like, oh, this person will not do something nasty in our country, that this person will not be on TNT. TNT means tago ng tago for Filipino term, meaning, you know, you have to hide and hide, which a lot of Filipinos are doing in the US, but I'm pretty sure now you cannot hide because of the Trump administration. And yes, I'm like thinking, wow, because of this good relationship between Singapore and other countries, they will never doubt that I will do something illegal, or I'm going to find work in that country, because they know that I'm coming back to Singapore. So yes, that's about it. I think that's my final 9 things why I like working and living here in Singapore. So if you are also like me, who is in Singapore, I would love to hear your thoughts about it. What do you think? Why you like also working, living here in Singapore? And if you also is like a foreigner like me who wants to come here in Singapore, please do come. Please apply for a job. Just try. It's free here. You'll never know. Probably Singapore is your, you know, it's your destination as well, just like me. You see me, I just woke up. I'm already 13 years here, going strong, me and my husband and my 2 kids. Yeah, it's really, really great here. So yeah, that's about it. If you like this kind of videos, and probably leave some comments below. What do you think will be my next topic, of what do you think about like I live here in Singapore or whatsoever? Do give me some ideas, because I'm just kind of newbie to all these things, but I'm like thinking I would like to share to you my thoughts of it. So yes, I think that's about it. If you like this kind of videos, like, subscribe, and click the bell button beside the subscribe button so you'll be notified whenever I upload new stuff from your mobile phone. And that's about it. I see you next time on my next video. Bye-bye.